Alright, so this is a new lesson in our training series, and we will see today how we can make an A3D logo from scratch using an PNG file. So this is the traditional way you can using this method to make any 3D logo from scratch. If you have a low quality word or have your low quality PNG, you can do that. Firstly, as usual, we'll add the reference here, and I'll check our reference to be an Blender. We can use this one. And I will move in the Z axis. Let's activate the selection filter here and disable this one. Of course, you can scale it maybe 0.5 and disable this value. We have here and two circles. Firstly, I will make the circle, I will put the cursor here, and after that, I will add a circle. We need here one and two and two. Around. This one will be 5 segment multiplied by 5, so maybe 24 for the circle. I will hit here F9. Let's again go to the design collection and add a circle. This one will be multiplied by 24, I will hit F9 and this one will be 24. And let's scale it down. For the MBT, we can decrease the opacity. And for the circle, let's move it here and move points here. As you can see, it's not perfect circle as you expect. Let's move it here, and I will move this edge here. Let's move this one, and that's it. Let's try to extrude and scale and move. Try to extrude and rotate and scale down and move. I'll move it here, and this one will be moved here, and this one also will be extruded such as this. Let's try. And after that, I'll select all edges, and this one also, and extrude scale, make a circle, move it here, and apply the scale. Then this one should be perfect circle, and I will scale in X to match our reference. You can move it here. All right, and scale. Let's make it perfect circle. Then another extrusion. And after that, let's extrude and fill. This is the Blender logo. And I will select this and space them. Then we can move it in the X axis such as this. Let's select all and extrude maybe minus 0.12. And for this one, we will make an inset. Extrude 0.05, and this value will be extruded 0.04, GZ 0.04. We have made the logo. the base. Of course, we will add some loop cuts to define our edges. One loop cut here in the base, and another loop cut here, and add the. So I will recalculate normals and add some loop cuts here to define our edges. And another loop cut here. EF. You can add another loop cut here and another loop cut here. And another loop cut here. EF. You can slide here. And let's slide it again to make it smooth. And this one also. I will dissolve and add again. EF. And add again. Such as this. This is the Blender logo, of course. We will add materials now and make it to 3. We don't need the reference anymore. And I think it's here. Let's check this one and make it smooth. And this one also. It will be smooth. That's fine. We have hard edges here, we want it all of these to be smooth, of course. So this method works on all 3D logos. I will make the base to be orange, so I will click here and add an orange value. For now, the orange will be here. So I will open Photoshop and map our color. So the hex value for orange is this value. And it will be roughness 0.15 and the specular 0.65. For this part, it will be white. So let's select and add the orange. And choose it to be white. RGB all values to be 1. Assign, don't forget to assign. And for this one, it will be. I will add loop cut here. And for this one, will be blue. Add orange again, and assign this one will be orange, blue. Alright, by using Photoshop, the value for blue has hex value of this value, and you can name, of course, blue. We are now done for logo and the materials. If you want to make any variations, you can make it metal or gold as you would like. And for now, we are now done. Of course, I think we need here this to be smooth. So using the quick flow, you can make it smooth such as this. Okay. And this one also will be smooth. And this one will be smooth. And this one will be smooth. This is the material for our logo, and I'll check this to be white, and this one also will be white. So this is our material in 3D. And as in the previous video, you can make another variations, and it's very simple to render. But I will show something how we can make it. Assume that this is your 3D logo. How you can make an overlay for your video. Let's add here the timeline, and let us make it will be 100 for second. and set origin to geometry. Alright, no problem. I will leave the origin here. And in the frame number 1, I will insert an rotation. In frame number 120, we can rotate around Z minus 300. This is full rotation, and insert another rotation. So let's see. Of course, we will make it linear, and let's see. Alright, I will add the origin to geometry, and let's again play. This is very fine, and we will make it. Let's try cycles. We didn't use it for a long time, and I will use bloom, ambient occlusion, space screen, space reflections, and the shadows will be here. And for film, it will be transparent. And let's add camera, and it will be square. And for the camera, maybe 75. Let's go here and we'll add light. Let's try the render. Okay, we will add light now. So we can add here an area light. Of course, EV doesn't work well with emission. So we need to add a rectangle, size in Y2, and power, let's try 200 here, and another value of light, and this may be disk, 103, let's try 2. Let's play. All right. I will decrease this value. And let's add another. Top light here, another area light. This one may be blue. Let's test the only this area light, and this is the rim here, right? Let's make it blue. With other two, you can have this value. I will leave it such as this. Let's center again to make sure that you have the logo in frame all the way. Alright, we have the logo. And after that, you can render, of course, as BNG from here 24. And you can render, because EV, you can render video or BNG as you'd like, and choose location, and after that you can render directory. Then in Premiere Pro or After Effect, you can sequence or collect files and make a video. So that's it for this tutorial. As you can see, we have made the logo from only an image, and we have make an animation video. This can be overlay for your video. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel.